I remember crying out to God, I just wanna live, I just wanna live. When I felt death so close, laying on that stretcher bed, when the lights went out and I was running out of breath, body limp, skin pale, face blue, in dire need of EMS, then he saved me. I remember crying out to God, I don't wanna live, I don't wanna live. When I couldn't take no more of this life, at the time I couldn't see it as a gift. When I couldn't beat addiction, beat up and struggling in my sin. Suicidal thoughts kept running through my head. Then he saved me. I know those two statements contradict. Life and death, completely opposite. But both gave me the same feeling, desperation. And both had the same outcome, salvation. So are they really that different? Not to the Christian. Who knows that death leads to resurrection? We know that death is for certain. We know that our loved ones passed on and it hurts us. But we also know that in the highs and lows, in the joy and pain, in the health and sickness, because the crucifixion led to the resurrection. In Jesus, it's all worth it. Because we are all living with a purpose. While many are temporarily without breath, we are all eternally purchased. So this graveyard here is really the land of the living for everybody who accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, believed he died on that cross, rose again, defeated death, then died to themselves, crucified their own flesh to receive his spirit. So they too will not perish, but have everlasting life. So this graveyard here is like a reflection of Easter. They are just laying and waiting, destined for their second resurrection. Am I jealous as I think they are just one step closer than me to fulfilling their destiny, their preordained path to life? This is just a part of their journey as they pass through life. So this isn't death after life for us believers, it's like life after life. So don't worry, wipe your tears, don't fear, lift up your head. We were given eternal life through Christ's blood that was shed, then given victory over death. The moment Jesus took his last breath, gave up his spirit, and that curtain was torn, the earth shook, the rock split, the tomb broke open, and that stone was finally rolled away. What can I say? He is not here, he is risen. And that same statement is the promise to us Christians. So remember the words of Jesus. They were written and read for a reason. His blood freed us. And just like we are looking forward to seeing him, I'm confident that he too is looking forward to see us.